No Truth, Justice, and Liberty in Nova Scotia. Written by a truth soldier. danieltowsey.wordpress.com. danieltowsey.photoshop.com. I understand that many Nova Scotian people will take offense to this statement. But the truth needs to be told. As some of you may know, I am an activist writer for truth, justice, and liberty, and I am the visionary folk photographer from the Great White North. In particular, I am going to speak about what I have discovered in the capital city, Halifax, of Nova Scotia. For those of you who have viewed my photograph albums at www.webshots.com/user/Towsey, and at www.webshots.com/user/danieltowsey, you will be able to confirm what I am about to tell you. I have done numerous photographic virtual tours of every significant public building, such as courthouses, churches, city hall, and the provincial legislature, and more. I have also photographed every monument, statue, plaque, and any other public signs. Unlike all other places I have visited in Ottawa, Quebec City, Montreal, and Toronto, etc., I could not find any signs of truth, justice, and liberty in Nova Scotia. I have searched and searched for signs of truth, justice, and liberty, and I cannot find it. My photographic virtual tours that can be viewed online attest to this. Not in one of these photos can I find any of these words written or mentioned. Unlike public institutions found in other places in Canada and the United States of America, Nova Scotia has never seen it fit to etch these important and noble words onto stone, brass, or paper. I then thought that this cannot be possible. So I then discovered that these words have never ever been spoken or uttered at any time by any members of any governments or corporate media in Nova Scotia, Canada. I was shocked to realize that this was very true indeed. I have asked members of the Nova Scotia legislature to consider getting these words erected somewhere. I have suggested that there be a plaque put up at all the entrances of all public buildings that claim to be part of the democratic process. I suggested that the plaques say this: be it known that you are entering an institution that is dedicated to the pursuit of truth, justice, and liberty. Keep out if you do not agree. I seriously doubt that any of these words will ever be spoken, whispered, written, or be posted in Nova Scotia. Nova Scotia's true history has always been cloaked in a veil of evil secrecy. For the self-serving and anti-democratic secret society of the Freemasonry claimed that they founded Nova Scotia. The Freemasons put themselves above truth, justice, and liberty and the democratic system that these words are founded on. The Freemasons are a self-serving evil group that will covertly destroy and kill anyone that challenges their control. Freemasons are in control of all key public positions, such as doctors, lawyers, judges, police, military, and the list goes on. This is not hard to believe and understand, as the Freemasons themselves make the claim that they founded Nova Scotia. I can prove this. Go see my news photographs album at my Webshots album online. Have a look at the pictures of the reconstruction of the 1785 Freemason Hall on Octorlony Street in the city of Dartmouth, Nova Scotia. There you will see the name of the building. They call it Founder's Corner. Nova Scotia has a most evil and dark underpinning. This evil secret society is destructive to anyone who has ever spoken words that are in the pursuit of truth, justice, and liberty. Just across the street is a soup kitchen that serves free hot meals to the hungry. It was originally named Margaret's House. Then they changed it to Feed Others of Dartmouth Society. Then for some unknown reason they took down the sign and also have nothing posted in any windows, so that anyone who has never been there before and is starving will never know for sure where the place is. So the place will only benefit insiders and not newcomers. I have often stood in the cold waiting in the lineup to that soup kitchen. I often spoke of the evils that go on in our society. I have told many of those in the lineup about the history of the building that we spent 3 years observing being built across the street. Until one day after I came out, a huge brutish man military machine type approached me and wanted to have a public discussion on my political views, especially pertaining to the war propaganda about Germany in World War II. All the while, the blonde-haired lady that runs the soup kitchen was right in front of us, leaning on the railing of the wheelchair ramp, and listened to our conversation. She could hear us very clearly, as the place is a very quiet place. This lady is the one responsible for this meeting and discussion taking place. She is the one that brought the harm to me that you are about to hear about. We sat in front of the Christ Church right across the street from the entrance to the soup kitchen. We discussed the Masons and the topic of the so-called Jewish Holocaust, and the theft, destruction and oppression of the Palestinians in their country came up. I mentioned that the Palestinians were murdered and the survivors were driven into the desert to die. I mentioned that only through the goodness of Christians from all over the world were the Palestinians able to survive. The good people of the world brought in food and tents to help these oppressed peoples. I expressed to this man that before the Second World War there were 50,000 real Jews living peacefully with the Arab and Christian Palestinians. And that after the Second World War there were now 6 million Jews living there in what they now call Israel, the most racist state on earth. These are the Jews that the world were told were killed by the Christian Germans. I said all those pictures we were shown of the Jews going to extermination camps was not true. I told him that the Zionists who controlled Hitler and took over Germany were actually showing us pictures of Jews that were being taken out of harm's way. They were heading to Palestine, which is now called Israel. After which the complete destruction of Christian Germany began, where the Zionist Freemasons controlled Allied bombers that went on their bombing campaign. They firebombed every town, hamlet, village and city in Germany, killing most of the Christian German population. During the last year of the war, most of the people of Germany were killed, injured and their homes destroyed. The firebombing always took place after 1 in the morning while the people slept. I told this man that the word Holocaust was a German word that the survivors were screaming after the firebombings. The word in German means to burn up in an inferno. That is why the war propaganda to cover up the real Holocaust was told to the rest of the world. We were told that the good Christians of Germany were evil and that they were killing Jews in ovens. The Zionists much earlier had committed their false flag operation where they broke all their own windows and told the world that the Christian Germans were evil and hated Jews. Then 3 months after Germany was completely destroyed and the war was over, the Allies arrived at one of the camps known as Auschwitz, where the support infrastructure such as food delivery had stopped because all the German people were dead. So we were shown images of dead and starving prisoners. We were then told that these prisoners were only Jews. Again, that was not true. The prisoners were mostly Christians. We were shown mass graves that the Allies dug to bury the dead. Many of the photographs were from other previous events from the First World War. The Zionist media wanted the world to believe that the Germans wanted to kill all the Jews. That was never true. The real Jews of Germany lived in happy peace with the German people all through Germany's great history. Germany was a country of the most beautiful peoples that were also known for being very intelligent and loving. The evil false Jews known as Zionists were the ones filled with hatred as always. Please note that anyone can be a Zionist and anyone can be a Jew. Be they black, white, Asian or whatever. Being a Jew is not a race. It is a religious name like those who follow Christianity are Christians. Those who follow Judaism are then called Jews. Just look at what they are doing to the Palestinians and what they have done to Lebanon. The lies of the war propaganda are now very easily proven if one chooses to seek the truth. Remember that International Zionist Jewry declared war on the Christian German peoples in 1933. Please also know that the Zionist cult was created and funded by the Rothschilds of England. The evils of the Zionist New World Order banksters are endless. So the next day as I walked across the street as I was leaving the soup kitchen, a pickup truck with two guys in their early 20s sat waiting for me to cross the street. As I crossed, they floored their pickup truck. Luckily for me, these killers did not realize that there was a sunken manhole cover in front of their truck. So, as they accelerated at full speed, their truck banged down really hard into this hole. The loud noise warned me and also slowed the truck's acceleration. It gave me the warning I needed to avoid being run over. They drove just in front of me at full speed and then immediately turned up into the Christchurch driveway, turning to face me, and sat there just staring at me. They had the most hateful and evil looks on their faces. They were so pissed off that they were not able to succeed in doing their evil to me. A week later, as I was riding my mountain bicycle down Portland Saint, they attempted to kill me again, when they drove a car over me. You can read about this in my article, How to Assassinate a Cyclist. So, as I said, there is no truth, justice, or liberty in this Zionist Freemason stronghold. Now you know that they want me dead for telling the truth and exposing their dark evil to the light of truth. I truly hope that my virtuous values as those of the murdered Christians from all over the world has not been for nothing. That depends on you learning and spreading the truth. Only truth will save us all from this Zionist New World Order. Please be warned that you, and most of us, are also in danger. This evil Zionist empire will never stop until it is exposed. You and every one of us are to be killed by the Zionist banksters who think they own this planet. They already erected humanity's tombstones. Please check out my article with pictures entitled, They Want You Dead is Written in Stone. There has been over 300 million Christians killed by the Zionists since their creation of the first corporation. Now they are wiping out and killing Islamic peoples. I ask you now to start fighting for truth, justice, and liberty. Please show me that my efforts have not been for nothing. Take this article of truth and all my many others, and spread the truth, for there can never be justice and liberty without you getting involved in spreading the truth. Signed, a truth soldier. I am a truth soldier, for God of goodness is the truth. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the Enlightenment. One more message for you to remember. Zionists hate beautiful people. For beauty shines out from inner beauty. Zionists have no inner beauty. Beauty brings out the rage and insanity from these insane Zionist money masters. They then use the power of money to destroy all that is beautiful. Life is like a mirror. What you see is what you show to the world. Zionism, like Israel, is a state of mind. The state of mind of Zionism is pure evil and hatred for all that is naturally beautiful on this planet. Zionism is a cult, a culture of hatred and evil. Zionism only cultivates and grows more hatred and evil. All evil resides in dark secret chambers of secret societies. This is why it is so important that all evil cults be exposed to the light of truth. That light comes from our God who created heaven that we live on. Earth is being destroyed by this evil and out of control cult. Please wake up out of the darkness and start carrying a lit candle of life. I do not want you to be killed by the evil Zionists. This has been a message from godliness.